In this video, we'll see the data transfer instructions present in 8051. So we'll directly use Keel Microgen 4 software for executing the instructions, checking the output, and learning the instructions in 8051. So first set of instructions is the data transfer instructions. So here I will just go through this program. First directive is ORG00hex, which stands for origin 00hex. 00hex is the address of the code memory in from which the program will start. So the first instruction is move a comma hash 0f2 hex. So one thing to remember here is that whenever the value starts from any letter from a to f, we have to precede it by zero. So this is required for the compiler. So that's why we have added here zero. So the actual value is f2. So with this instruction, the value f2 will be copied to accumulator. So in any instruction, if a hash symbol is there, then it means that it is a immediate addressing mode instruction. In this, the value present after this hash symbol, that will be copied to the destination register. So here the destination register is accumulator. So this f2 value will be copied to accumulator. Now this instruction is of 2 bytes. One byte is required for storing the opcode and one byte is required for storing this value. So this is a 2-byte instruction. Let's check the output of this instruction. So I'll just debug the code and now I can check the output of this instruction. So if I go for this single stepping, I will get the output of that. So accumulator will have value f2. So here the accumulator is there. So we have got f2 in accumulator. Next instruction is move r1 comma hash 55 hex. So again, it is an immediate addressing mode instruction because a hash symbol is present in the instruction. And the meaning of this instruction is that 55 is the value or data that will be copied to r1. So here again, this instruction is of 2 bytes. 1 byte is required for storing the opcode and 1 byte is required for storing the value 55 hex. So let's check the output of this. So 55 hex will be now copied to R1. R1 is right now is having value 00. If I execute that instruction, I get here 55 hex. Next instruction is move 15 comma hash 99 hex. So again, hash symbol is there. So it is an immediate addressing mode instruction. So in this again, 15, I have not written hex over here. So this 15 is the decimal value. So in this instruction, again, 99 hex will be copied to 15 decimal location present in RAM. So this instruction is again of immediate addressing mode. And it is a 3-byte instruction. Why? Because 1 byte is required for opcode. And 1 byte is required for storing this 15 value and 1 byte is required for storing 99 value. So total 3 bytes are required for this instruction. So let's check the output over here in the memory window. So I can type here D colon and the address location. Here I am having 15 hex as the destination address location of RAM. So right now it is having value 00. So when I execute that instruction, I should get there 99. So I have got here 99 hex value. Next is move dptr comma hash 1234 hex. Again, this is a immediate addressing mode instruction. So this 1234 hex value will be copied to dptr and it is a 3-byte instruction because 1 byte is required for storing the opcode, 1 byte is required for storing a higher byte, and the other byte is required for storing the lower byte. So this is actually a 16-bit value. So it requires 2 bytes and opcode requires 1 byte. So this instruction is of 3 bytes. So if I execute that instruction, I get 1234 in the DPTR register. So DPTR is actually the data pointer which can be used for pointing to the external or internal RAM memory location. Then next instruction is move R0 comma A. Now in this instruction, both the operands are registers. So this instruction is of register addressing mode. Now the meaning of this instruction is that the value present in accumulator will be copied to R0 register. So if I execute this instruction, the value present in accumulator, that is F2, will be now copied to R0. So I have got here F2. So this is a 1-byte instruction because it does not have any value as the operand. So it requires only opcode for representation. So it is a 1-byte instruction. Next instruction is move a comma 67 hex. Now this instruction is a direct addressing mode instruction because this 67 hex is the direct address and the value present at this address location will be copied to accumulator. And this instruction is of 2 bytes, because 1 byte is required for storing the opcode of this instruction and 1 byte is required for storing this address. So total 2 bytes are required for this instruction. So the meaning is I should check the 67 hex address location. So here I have value 00, so I will put some value over here, for example 47 hex. So when this instruction is executed, I should get 47 in accumulator. So I have got here 47 hex in the accumulator. Next instruction is move 34 hex comma 67 hex. Now this is again a direct addressing mode instruction, because both the operands are direct addresses. These addresses are of RAM memory. So the value present in 67 hex will be copied to the value to the address location 34 hex. So this instruction is of 3 bytes, because 1 byte is required for storing the opcode, 1 byte is required for storing the address 34 hex, and 1 byte is required for storing the address 67 hex. So total 3 bytes are required. So if I execute that, so right now 67 is having 47 value, so that will be copied to 34 hex. So I can check here the address location 34 hex. So I have got the same value over here, that is 47 hex. Next instruction is move 44 hex comma R1. Now in this instruction again we have one operand as the register and the one operand as the direct address. So this instruction is of direct addressing mode, because for register addressing mode both the operands should be registers. So here in this case only one operand is register and one is direct address. So this instruction is of direct addressing mode. So the meaning of this instruction is that the value present in R1 will be copied to 44 hex address location. So we have value in R1 as 55. So that value should be copied to 44 hex address location. So I will go at 44 hex. Right now it is having value 00. So after executing that instruction, I get here 55, which is the value present in R1. So this instruction is of 2 bytes, because 1 byte is required for opcode and 1 byte is required for storing this value, that is 44 hex. So it is a 2 byte instruction. Next instruction is move R0 comma hash 33 hex. So this is again a immediate addressing mode instruction, because hash symbol is present in the instruction and this 33 hex is called as the data, immediate data. So this 33 hex will be copied to accumulator. And it is a 2 byte instruction. 1 byte is required for the opcode and 1 byte is required for 33 hex, storing 33 hex value. So if I execute that, I get 33 in R0 register. Next instruction is move A comma at the rate R0. So this is the indirect addressing mode instruction. So whenever we have at the rate symbol in any instruction, it means that that instruction is of indirect addressing mode. So the meaning of this instruction is that R0 will be used as a memory pointer. So it is going to point to some memory location and the value present at that memory location will be copied to accumulator. So right now R0 is having value 33 hex. So it is going to point to 33 hex memory location of internal RAM and the value present at that location will be copied to accumulator. So let's check the 33 hex location. So here we are having value 00. So I'll put here some value, for example 88 hex. So when I execute this instruction, the value 88 hex will be copied to accumulator. So let's check that. So when I execute that, I got here 88. Now this instruction is of 1 byte, because there is no operand with any value. Both the operands are registers. So it requires only opcode for its representation. So it is a 1 byte instruction. Next instruction is move 20 hex comma at the rate R0. So this instruction is used for copying the contents of the memory location pointed by R0 to the internal RAM location 20 hex. Now here both the operands are different. That is, one operand is having a pointer and the other operand is having a direct address. So this instruction is actually of indirect addressing mode. Why? Because before using this instruction, we must initialize R0. Only then it will work properly as expected. So this instruction is of indirect addressing mode. R0 is pointing to the address location 33 hex. On that we are having 88 value. So this value will be copied to 20 hex when I execute that instruction. So if I put here 20, so right now it is having value 00. So if I execute that, I get there 88 hex. Now this instruction is of 2 bytes. because one byte is required for opcode and one byte is required for storing the value 20 hex. That is nothing but the address, direct address. Next instruction is move at the rate R0 comma hash 44 hex. Again, same thing. In this instruction, we are having memory pointer and a hash symbol. So this instruction is actually of indirect addressing mode, because whenever we want to use this instruction, we have to initialize the pointer, only then this instruction will work properly. So the meaning of this instruction is that 44 hex value will be copied to the memory location pointed by this R0 pointer. So R0 is having value 33 hex. So when I execute that instruction, 33 hex address will have the value 44 hex. So we have got here 44 hex. Next, this instruction is of 2 bytes, because 1 byte is required for opcode and 1 byte is required for storing this value. Next instruction is move dptr comma hash 1111 hex. Now using this instruction, we can copy any value in data pointer register, which is a 16 bit register. So if I execute that, I get the value in the dptr register. Now this is again an immediate addressing mode instruction, because we are having hash symbol in the instruction, and this is the immediate data. Next, move x at the rate dptr comma a. So move x stands for external RAM. So whenever we want to transfer any data from accumulator to external RAM, at that time we have to use a data pointer. So this data pointers can be either dptr, or it can be R0, or it can be R1 register. So here we have used dptr as the pointer. So with this, the value present in accumulator will be copied to the external RAM location pointed by dptr. So for external memory, we have to type here x colon and the address. So here the value present in dptr is 1111 hex. So I have written here 11. So here the value is 0, we'll put some value like 77 hex. So this value will be replaced by the value present in accumulator. So accumulator is having value 88 hex. So when I execute this instruction, I get here 88 hex. This instruction is of 1 byte, because there is no any operand having any value. So this requires only opcode for its representation. So it is a 1 byte instruction. Next instruction is move R1 comma hash 90 hex. Again, it is a immediate addressing mode instruction. So 90 will be copied to R1 register. So R1, we have got 90. Next, move x a comma at the rate R1. Now here we have used R1 as the pointer, which we have initialized to the address location 90 hex. And since we are going to access the external RAM, we have to type here x colon 90 hex. So on 90 hex, we are having value 00. So I will put some random value over here, for example, 44 hex. So that value will be copied to accumulator. So when I execute this instruction, I get 44 hex in the accumulator. So this instruction is again of 1 byte, and it is of indirect addressing mode. So whenever in any instruction, if we have at the rate symbol, it means that the instruction is of indirect addressing mode. And it is a 1 byte instruction. Only 1 byte is required for the opcode, and there are no any operands with any value. Next instruction is clear A. Now this is actually an instruction of implied addressing mode, because the default operand here is accumulator. We cannot have any other register as the operand in this instruction. So that's why this is a instruction of implied addressing mode, and it is a 1 byte instruction. So with this, the contents of accumulator will be cleared. So it is right now 44. So it will become now 0. Next instruction is move dptr comma hash 40. So 40 will be copied to dptr. This we have already seen. Next, this instruction move c a comma at the rate a plus dptr. This instruction is called as indexed addressing mode instruction, because here we are having one address present in dptr and other address is present in accumulator. So the address present in dptr is called as base address, and address present in accumulator is called as offset address. So when these two addresses are added together, and whatever value is generated on that address location, some value will be present, that value will be copied to accumulator. Another thing to notice over here is we are having move c as the mnemonic. So c stands for code memory. So we are going to access the internal code memory, and we are going to store the value in accumulator. So let's see here, we have 40 in dptr and accumulator is having 0, So it is going to access the code memory of 40 hex location. So for accessing the code memory, we have to type here C:40 hex. So it is right now having value 00. So I will put some value over there, for example 79 hex. So this 79 hex will be copied to accumulator when this instruction is executed. So we can see here 79 we have got in the accumulator. Now this instruction is also of 1 byte because it just requires an opcode for its representation. It is not having any value in the instruction. Next instruction is again clear accumulator, which is used for clearing the accumulator. This instruction move C A comma at the rate A plus PC is again used for copying the contents of internal code memory to the accumulator. Now here the base register is different. It is PC, that is program counter, and A is the accumulator. So here program counter value is 26 hex and accumulator is having value 00. So when this instruction is executed, the program counter will be incremented by 1. So the new value in program counter will be 27 hex. So the value present at 27 hex address location in the code memory, that value will be copied to accumulator. So let's see what we are having at 27 hex address location. So we are having C0 hex. So this C0 hex will be copied to accumulator. So when I execute that, I get here C0 hex. So this instruction is again of 1 byte. It is just requiring opcode for its representation. Next instructions are related to stack. So stack is again a reserved part of memory which can be used for storing temporary data. So we are having a stack pointer. So stack pointer is default. It is initialized to address 07 hex. So this is the stack pointer. So 07 hex is the RAM memory location. And stack pointer is pointing to 07 hex address location. First instruction is push ACC. ACC stands for accumulator. So whenever we are using this push instruction, we have to use ACC instead of accumulator. So the contents present in accumulator will be pushed onto the stack. So stack pointer will be incremented by 1 and the value present in accumulator will be stored at that location. So stack pointer is having 7. So it will be incremented by 1 and so the value will be 8, and at that location the contents of accumulator will be stored. So right now it is having value 00. So when this instruction is executed, the value present in accumulator, that is C0, will be copied to that location. So you can see here C0 we have got as the output. So this instruction is again of 1 byte. So it just requires opcode for storing the instruction. The next instruction is push 01 hex. Now in this case again 01 is the address location of RAM. So instead of using the register names R0 to R7, we have to use the addresses of those registers. So 01 is the address of R1 register. So whatever value is present in R1 register, that is here in this case it is 90, that will be stored onto the stack. So at this next location, the value 90 will appear when I execute that instruction. So as you can see, 90 we have got here. So this instruction is of 2 bytes because 1 byte is required for storing the opcode and the other byte is required for storing this value. Next instruction is pop instruction. So whenever we want to take anything out of the stack, at that time we have to use the pop instruction. So the meaning of this instruction is that the value pointed by the stack pointer will be popped out of the stack and it will be stored in 30 hex address location of internal RAM. So the value pointed by stack is now 90 hex. So when I execute this, I should get 90 hex at 30 hex location. So I will go to 30 hex location. So here we are having value 00. So when I execute that, I will get there 90 hex. Next instruction is related to exchanging the data. So exchange A comma R3. So the value present in R3 will be copied to accumulator and value present in accumulator will be copied to R3. So the value present in R3 is 00 and value present in accumulator is C0. So these values will be simply exchanged. And this is a 1 byte instruction because it requires just opcode for its representation. And the addressing mode is the register addressing mode because both the operands are registers. Next instruction is XCH A comma 30 hex. Here 30 hex is the direct address. So this instruction is of direct addressing mode. So the meaning of this instruction is that the contents of 30 hex will be exchanged with the contents of accumulator. So on 30 hex location, we are having 90. So this 90 will be copied to accumulator, and at this location we'll get the value of accumulator, that is 00. So if I execute that, I get here 90 hex and I get here 00 hex. So this instruction is again of 2 bytes because it requires 1 byte for opcode and 1 byte for storing the address. Next instruction is XCH A, at the rate R0. Again, here R0 acts as a pointer. So since we are having at the rate symbol in the instruction, it is an indirect addressing mode instruction. So the meaning of this instruction is that the data pointed by R0 will be exchanged with the data present in accumulator. So accumulator will have the data pointed by R0. So let's see, R0 is having value 33 hex. So at 33 hex, I am having 44 value. So when I execute this instruction, this 44 value will be copied to accumulator, and the value present in accumulator, that is 90 hex, will be copied to this 33 hex location. So let's see. So I've got here 90 and I've got here 44. So the values have exchanged. So again, it is a 1 byte instruction. 1 byte is required for opcode. And the final instruction is that XCH D A, at the rate R0. So this instruction is just used for exchanging the lower nibble of both the operands. So here one operand is accumulator and the other operand is the indirect register, which is pointing to some memory location. So here in this case, it is pointing to the address location 33 hex. So at 33 hex, we are having 90 as the value, and in accumulator we are having 44 as the value. So when this instruction is executed, the lower nibble, that is 4, and here the lower nibble is 0, those will be exchanged. So I will get here 40 and I will get here 94 hex. So let's see. So if I execute that, I've got here 40 hex and I've got here 94 hex. So this instruction is again of indirect addressing mode, and it is of 1 byte. 1 byte is required for storing the opcode. So this is about the data transfer instructions available in 8051. So another thing to remember is that I have just shown some of the examples, but other examples are also available. That so instead of R0, I can use any register from R0 to R7 as a operand. Again, I can use it in reverse way, move A, R0, and so on. So these operands can be exchanged, except for the immediate addressing mode. This immediate data is always available at source location. It cannot appear at the destination location. So that is about the data transfer instructions. In the next class, we'll see the arithmetic and logical instructions in 8051. Thank you.